Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. Today's video we will be speaking with Stefan from WeAreDevelopers. Now the reason why I wanted to do this one, I reached out to the Coda team and asked them if there's any specific use cases of Coda being used in the wild. And of course there are, with the community templates area. And I thought it was a great opportunity to speak with Stefan and his team about how they're using it. So first off, Stefan, great to have you here.
Thank you. And, great to be here.
Definitely. And maybe you can give us a bit of introduction to We Are Developers, because it sounds like you're doing some quite exciting stuff with the events and the talent area.
Yes. So We Are Developers is a company whose goal it is to connect developers with companies. And we do that with two things. On the one hand, we have our Congress, and in June, there is the upcoming World Congress in Berlin. We will have 10,000 developers there. So now we can say it's the world's largest developer congress in the world. No, that's too much. And on the other hand, we were wondering, while we were doing the Congress, hey, you know, we should actually give people also the possibility to connect with the companies and with other developers when there is no Congress, which is the rest of the year. So we created the platform where we connect developers with the jobs companies have to offer. But we do not accept every company, and it's kind of a developer is in the driver's seat concept. So the developer has all the power, you know. He can say if he wants to talk to a person, it's not that you can talk, the company can like browse developers. This is, we do not want that, because yeah, we are as developers, we hate spam. Everybody hates spam.
Yeah, definitely. Well, it sounds quite exciting, and the conference looks mental busy, which is good.
Yeah,
definitely. So maybe first question I had for you was, where did you first discover Coda? Because there are so many project managers out there. Where did you guys find it?
I think it was way back when Coda was like coming out, and I was reading something on the interwebs. I guess it was Product Hunt, where it's like, hey, this is cool. And it's kind of, I don't know what it is, but it just works. And I applied to get access. And then I had a look at it, and it's like, finally somebody made a usable interface where you can play with text and you can play with tables and reference stuff, and amazing instant love.
Because it sort of met all your needs straight away. And how did I think it's what you know, that's one of those tools that takes a bit of time to get used to. Originally, how did you and your team sort of warm to it? Did it take a bit of time to get into it?
The time to get into it was quite short.
Okay.
Because in the past we used some spreadsheet stuff. But spreadsheets are like not even the not wanted cousin of Coda, because it's much easier to think in the, or to get into this Coda thing for people who have to do a lot of development, because it's so logical. It works like a database. And it's also easy to grasp for people who said, oh, what's that, a new tool? Yeah, like our sales guys, oh my god, it's something I have to learn. And it's like, they had a look at it, and it's like, oh my god, that's so simple. That's like sending an email.
It's like really relatable, because like documents have already been out there for years. So it was quite easy to get on. Well, that's really good to hear. And then in terms of like how you guys use Coda, like, could you give like a demo of how you guys go about that these days?
Yes. So our main use at the moment is we're doing our OKRs with it. So that's objectives and key results for the people who do not know what OKRs are. And we really love it because it helps us in the process. What you usually do when you do an OKR is that you have your objective on a very high level, and you break it down into key results, which tell you how do I know if these key results are met, and how do I know if I reach that objective? And the thing is that most of the time, the first thing which comes to your mind is, okay, I have to measure something, so I need a table, yeah, and I need to write down numbers somewhere. But the fun thing with OKRs is that what you take as your objective is very general. So let's say the objective, here I have the platform. The objective is increase revenue. That's quite simple, a simple objective. And the key result is just, I want to have this and this many thousands of euro in revenue in Q1, for instance. And what we do is we also attach a risk, yeah, which we can use the nice thing that you can have these icons next to it. So we have all these lightning bolts where you can choose between 1 and 3 lightning bolts. And then also completion. And we said, okay, completion, we don't need it down to the 1%. It doesn't matter to us. Yeah? The completion would actually something like in a movie rating that you have 5 stars, and this is what is with us. And we just, when we start and we see something to come up, then it's 1 star. And so 5 stars means 1 star is approximately 20%. And for us, that's more than enough. And if we reach our key results by 80%, then we are happy. If we reach over 100%, this means we need to be much more bold when we go for this goal we want to go towards.
Yeah.
And what Coda helps us here is not only that we can use it in meetings with everybody, but what Coda also helps us with is what you do with OKRs. You go down one level and this gets inherited down. So on the lower level, the objectives and key results, they somehow have to pipe up. So there is an upper key result. And in Coda, we are heavy users of using other tables as fields in new tables. So, and then you can inherit it down and down and down. And that's wonderful because you can calculate it the way up.
Yeah, that's it. And have you found like just general things like meetings, admin, everyday activities, have they been easier when you've got this view, this OKR view?
Yes, very much. What it did help us productivity wise is management has to spend like at the beginning ages to find out what the right OKR is for every department. And so at the end of the day, everybody in management has understood what the actual objective is on a higher level and on the lower level, and how we will interact. And it's so easy also to grasp for everybody else on the team that it's sometimes giving me goosebumps.
Maybe a bit too easy.
And yeah, it's hyper-transparent. Yeah,
yeah, definitely.
We use it so that everybody can see it. So it's not a secret, and it's out there, and it's like a dashboard even. Yeah.
Yeah. How many of your team go into it every single day? How big is your team that use Coda every day?
The people who are Coda users are 35. And each and every one of them goes in every day. This is also because a key result has initiatives under it. So it's like breaking it down into actual things you will do, actions, to-dos. And these we also do in Coda. So you go in and see how far is Carl without going two doors on and say, hey, how's it going? What are you doing? Everybody knows what is doing. And also meeting-wise, every day we have a stand-up in the morning where the OKRs are like, they are the map which everything relates to. So when we talk about the obstacles we managed to solve and the initiatives we are planning, they all relate somehow to this thing. So there is always this link. It's kind of like the links in this data structure. They jumped over to the real world. No, it's
I know what you mean. Like, and that can really save you time. Like, even knowing who's doing what and when, and then they update it in real time. So that's pretty good.
Yeah.
And one of the questions I had for you, because like obviously like you guys now using Coda pretty efficiently. Are there any things that you would recommend for like new teams that could be like agencies, sales teams, when they're getting on Coda? Are there any like best practices that you'd recommend? Obviously that's a tough question.
No, it's actually, I just have to think back. What we did a lot was having a look at all the templates which exist, because it's so many templates which can give you so many ideas on just how to manage your data, and also the tutorials which are built into Coda. They are wonderful. Yeah, they tell you, if you work through the tutorials, it takes you, depends on, if you go for a coffee, it will take you 1 hour, then you can have a chat next to it, because it's so easy. And you will have the basics, and then you will see stuff and like, how did they do it? Then this is where it starts. It's like, oh my god, yeah, why didn't I do that?
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, and it's like inception when you get going. Like, you can go really deep with it. So, and I bet it helps being the developer and sort of in that community as well, in terms of being like seeing other people use it in that way, for sure. Brilliant.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for coming on, Stefan, and taking your time to share a bit more about Coda. Naturally, I think people will watch this and be like, okay, Coda is actually something that I might be interested in. So we'll include the link below, but we'll also include the demo one that you did. Is that right? In the so that people can see how you guys are using it in the community. But I appreciate you coming on, and good luck for the conference in June, if I don't talk to you by then.
Thank you.
Cheers.
It was nice being here.
Yeah, definitely.